What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, Big Boy Fast Giant TV, and tonight I'm going my AEW Dynamite review on highlights. So if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys please hit that subscribe button because I'm on the road to 4K. Follow my social media, my Twitter, my Instagram, and TikTok, and Twitch, and Discord down below in the description. And go check out my WWE NXT review on highlights that's up on the channel. Alright, without being said, let's talk about AEW Dynamite. Now, AEW Dynamite was a good show. That's all I gotta say. It's Wednesday night, you know what that means. AEW Dynamite comes to you live from Boston, Massachusetts, as the commentators welcome us to the show. We're kicking off tonight with a huge 8-man tag. Alright, so we get an eight-man tag match. 8-man tag team match. Swerve and Our Glory and the Gun Club versus FTR and the Acclaim. Now, this match was too long. Alright. I'll first is the Gun Club to a moderate reaction followed by a great reaction for Swerve and Keith Lee. This is going to be a fun showcase of some fun of the best teams in AEW. And also the Gun Club. The top guys are out next as FTR gets a great ovation as the triple champs make their way down to the ramp. Dax throws the belt off and celebrates with the fans as yo, the Acclaim are here as Mascara raps about Tom Brady. Herschel, Walker, Kyrie Irving, and beating two snakes and the bad you know what boys. Billy Gunn immediately runs down and takes out Swerve in the ring. The faces hold him back as even BJ Whitmer comes down to alleviate the situation. Dax and Colton starting off as Colton goes to work early on Dax and hits a nice standing dropkick, then tags his brother in. Austin with a big right hand and asks the crowd chants, you know what, boys, as Dax comes back with a shoulder block and Kyle Pole into the corner. Big chop to Colton as Austin gets a shot from all four men. Gunn able to get away and tag Swerve, who quickly attacks Cash first with body blows, but Cash counters with a tilt a world backbreaker. Caster tags in as Swerve tags in Lee. Both men circle each other and go shot for shot. Caster with a super kick as he fights off the heels as now all eight men are in the corner giving 10 punches. Lee throws Caster off and they quadruple team Lee with FTR sending Eddie Bounce and Mass Caster into Lee and send him out of the ring. The Acclaim sisters as we go to commercial. We're back from commercial. Swerve has Dax in a headlock as he tries for a somersault clothesline, but Dax with a German. Austin tags in as Dax struggles to reach one of his partners. Dax with a big back drop on Austin as Colton tags in but miss a splash and in a hot tag to Bowens. He takes out both guns now with a vicious elbow to the back of Swerve's head. Bowens with a famouser on Colton now. On Colton Gunn now as Austin pulls Max out of the apron. Gunn Club hit the big rig. 1-2, no. All eight men regrouped in their corners. As Lee is recruiting, but they eventually all three of them on each other. Colton and Cash go overboard as the Acclaim have Swerve isolate. Lee catches a Bowden Hurricanrana onto a prime bomb and takes out Caster and Anthony Bowens. The audio is fed keeps counting out. Swerve with a tornado off the turnbuckle to get the guns and the Acclaim. Dax with a huge superplex onto all all the other men outside the ring. My feet keeps glitching out. Dax gets Austin in the ring now, but Austin with a series of jabs. Dax takes him out and sharpshooter by Dax. Colton breaks it up, but miss a famous arrival by Bones. Then a mic drop, big rig by FTR. 1, 2, 3. The winner of the match, FTR and the Acclaimed. The match was, like I said earlier, the match was too long, but it was fun at the same time. Alright, post-match, all four men raise their belts and celebrate in the ring. The commentators talk about MJF in his interview on Pardon My Take and cut to a video of that interview. He says he is worried about Full Gear and how people don't understand why it's the most important in wrestling. This could be the crowning of a new face of a generation. His name's Flair, the Rock, Cena, Hogan, Dusty Rhodes, etc. He says that who MJF is, all he has to do to X his name into history and have a long, fruitful region. He thinks Mox is a scumbag piece of you know what from the slums. But he respects him. He calls him unethical, but says he respects all his sacrifice and says he is the best wrestler on God's green earth. It ends at Full Gear because MJF is the guy who can do everything. TV, movies, talk show, etc. He can bring pro wrestling back to where people can talk about it again. He's sick of waiting his turn. He talks about his first match being against a neck tattoo Matt Fall on pay-per-view, and his return was mirrored by a press conference. He is grabbing the spotlight and comes Full Gear. The devil gets his due. All right, so we go to commercial break. We see a Stokely halfway video. He talks about how he and MJF used to see eye to eye and how now he just, you know what, riding Moxley. He says he doesn't need his best friend anymore. See you in hell, MJF. All right, so we get the AEW World Title Eliminator Tournament match. All Ego Ethan Page versus Eddie Kingston. I'm gonna say this match was pretty good. My former employer Ethan Page makes his way out to the ring to a great ovation. Kingston follows suit with Ortiz at his side, and it's great to see him as always. The winner gets a shot at Moxley / MJF. And winter is coming. They lock up in jockey for position as the commentators run down the history together. Kingston in control early with a headlock as Page fights him off. Kingston with a couple of chops, but Page cuts him off with a middle rope shoulder block. Kingston rolls out and Page files off the apron with a shoulder block again. Slap and stomp to Eddie is as both men get into the ring. Page gets reversed with a knee and double underhook suplex for a two count. Page is able to counter Eddie and whips him hard into the corner, then follow up with a nasty suplex on the floor as we go to commercial. We back from the break, suplex by Eddie for a close two count on Page as Stokely watches on. Both men slug it out on their knees in a classic yay boo spot. Up their feet now as they keep slugging, but Eddie with a big chop. Series of chops and a big DDT. 1, 2, no. That was a very close two count. Eddie tries for an exploder, but Page fights out. Eddie fights him off and is able to hit the exploder. Stretch palm lock in a Page and Paige is tapping. Stokely is on the apron, but Ortiz finally yanks him off the apron. As Paige comes back with a huge boot and roundhouse kick, Eddie cuts Paige off at the top and bites him, but Paige sends Eddie into the post. Eddie sets up a huge Eagles Edge, holy, you know what, 1, 2, 3. The winner of the match, Ethan Page. This was a, you know what I'm saying, this match was pretty good. Post-match, Renee interviewed Rush and Dark Order. He claims Rush will win it all and that number 10 will get the first title shot while the Dark Order isn't going to get one ever. John Silva calls him a Rush bag as they scuffle and we cut to the ring. Aria Davari is in the ring and offers his own butler for the TNT title, which enraged Warlow, and he comes out, and this is an opening challenge, apparently. So the TNT championship match, Aria Davari versus Warlow. This was a quick match. Warlow is flanked by Joe as he makes his way out to the ring. Warlow fakes taking the deal and sends the butler outside. Warlow destroys Davari with a headbutt as Warlow hits the wind up lariat. He signals for the powerbomb sympathy and kills Davari with a quartet of powerbombs and steps on his chest for the win. The winner of the match, Warlow. Post-match, Warlow immediately calls out Hobbs. And he obliged. He says, we do this on my time. Warlow says, finally, he has a suitable opponent. And Warlow says he is going to keep the TNT title and take every championship as Samoa Joe wipes out Warlow. Samoa Joe choking out Warlow. Warlow is completely out cold as Hobbs is laughing on the ramp. Samoa Joe stares at Warlow and whispers something as Hobbs screams, I'll give you two at... Give you two at Joe. Now, I did not expect Samoa Joe to turn heel. I did not see this one coming. So, Samoa Joe just turned on Raw, as you can see the thumbnail. All right, now that's out the way. Let's keep going. Up next is the face-to-face with Dr. Britt Baker and Saraya. Oh, I was ready for this. So, we go to commercial break. Renee is in the back with Jay and the baddies. Is it... Announced at Full Gear, it's Nia versus Jay for the TBS belt. She talks some trash and abruptly walks off. All right, so we get a promo. We get a segment from Dr. Britt Baker and Saraya face off. This was a good promo right here. And I'm glad Saraya let her emotions out during this segment right here. I enjoyed it. Tony Schiavone is in the ring as he introduced her very good friend, Dr. Britt Baker, DMD. She strolls out to the ring and eventually makes her way in the ring. Saraya is announced next as she comes out to a huge pop. Baker looks none too pleased in the ring as Saraya dances and sings around the ring. Before she turns on the corner, Tony is in the middle of both women and starts with Saraya. She says, people are wondering who I won't wrestle. They did test, but unfortunately for Britt, I am 100% cleared. The crowd goes absolutely bananas as the emotion takes over Saraya and she screams, AEW, it's my house. Baker says, anything more fickle than an AEW fan. Do you still know how to do this? We aren't clear. You come at me every day, and I think I know why. I built AEW from the ground up. That superstar like you wanted to move into, and I am, you know what, proud of it. The crowd chants DMD. The pride turns to... resentment when you skip in here and call it your house. I'll call it funny. You didn't lay a single brick. I know why you're obsessed with me. I am everything you wish you could have been. If you think I'm lying, let me remind you. You left your house and walked into mine. I regret to inform you. We don't take walk in, so you know what makes an appointment. I think it's cute considering you got everything given to you and you only been here 3 years. I done it 17. You have no idea what it takes to be a star or even a superstar. I got hit by a car and wrestled someday. I handed out resumes and turned down because I was a female. I done MSG O2 Tokyo Dome, and now I'm in front of ungrateful. You know what? You don't know what it takes. I battled my drug addiction publicly. I am giving my career and neck out for this business. This is the biggest match of your career. You versus me at Full Gear. I can't wait for that match. Saraya drops the mic and then stares off. Britt tries for a cheap shot, but Saraya catches her and hits a page turner, gets out of the ring, and she walks off. She celebrates as Baker is pissed at ringside. Now, this was a good promo by Saraya and Britt Baker. I enjoyed this promo. All right, I enjoyed the segment. Lexi is talking with Sanjay. The Factor, Lethal, and Stunnam done haunted into us with the best friends. QT talks trash to Orange Cassidy, and Orange Cassidy immediately accepts a match versus QT on Rampage. Best friends call Doug and Lethal scumbags, and Trent challenges Lethal. So we get Trent versus Jay Lethal. This was a decent match. Trent makes his way out as Lethal takes him out from behind. Lethal immediately works on the knee of Trent as he tries to fight back, but Lethal sends him knees first over the steps. A la Mick Foley, Sanjay and Stunner make their way down to the ring. Lethal sends Trent to the ring as the bell finally rings. Lethal with the chops to Trent and keeps working on his knee. Lethal attempts a top rope maneuver, but Trent counters. Trent firing shots down on Lethal, but Lethal takes out the leg and hits a knee breaker / dragon screw combo as Don Hansen and Chuck Taylor makes their way down as we go to commercial. Back from commercial, Lethal is up top as he looks for the elbow, but Trent gets the knees up. That hurt Trent just as much as both men struggle to their feet. Trent with a huge German suplex, and then followed with a half and half suplex as well. Trent with a clothesline in the corner, but Lethal counters a DDT. Trent sends Lethal hard into the corner and hits a spinning DDT. 1-2, no. Trent still favoring the knee as both men head up the top as Trent hits a nasty avalanche half and half, then a knee strike by Trent. He sets up for the Storm Zero, but Sanjay is on the apron. Don Hansen is up and curse Sanjay, but Stunnam lays out Don Hansen. Lethal with a big kick to Trent, and Lethal and Jackson 1-2-3. The winner of the match, Jay Lethal. That was a decent match. Tony is on the ramp interviewing Sanjay and Lethal as Sanjay tells him to shut up and sit down. He's delivering his promise last week as Jeff Jarrett's music hits and makes his way out. This is now a 5/5 show regardless. Jeff Jarrett says, after a million views of my debut, the question is why. When a friend calls, a friend shows up, I show up to help. And we started our plan last week. He talks about the history between Jay Lethal, Sanjay Dutt, and himself, giving nods to Global Force as well as Impact. He praised Stanham as being a legitimate and giant, and calls out fake giants and red skinny jeans, Braun Strowman. So Jeff Jarrett was taking shots at Braun Strowman. He praised his NBA accomplishment of being the only Indian player. He talks about putting people in body bags, and he calls out a guy for winding him up for time. He chased the guy down the guy down with the guitar as Sanjay Dutt stops him as Jeff Jarrett's music hits. Renee is in the back with Jack Perry as she asks about him and Luchasaurus. He says Christian and Luchasaurus didn't decide when it's over, and what happened last week was just the beginning. He says he will challenge them face to face on Rampage in regards to Full Gear. Wild things. Moxley makes his wonderful entrance through the crowd as we will hear from him next. So we get John Moxley address the crowd. John Moxley is coming by Regal as he stokes in the absolute love and abortion of every single fan in attendance. Sir William Regal, how old was I when we met 25/26? I was young, full of piss and vinegar and no Arthur's yet. I thought I figured it out. I ran my mouth. I wanted to be fear and respect like you. So to get that, I picked a fight with you, and it didn't go well. You tortured me, kicked the you know what out of me, and it pissed me off. It drove me to work hard, grow and evolve. When I had a shot, I knocked you out with a knee. Whip your ear near off. You finally said, now the real work begins. Moxley says he reminds him of MJF. He talks about their first match, and I beat him badly and let him know where he stood. Now it's full circle, but what's different this time? Who is MJF? We know the rich, fake JCPenney clothing guy. He talks the talk of a big time champ, but I am a multi-millionaire, multi-champ. He calls himself a pillar without never having weight. He laughs at MJF, calling himself the devil. I have seen the devil. I met him and looked in his eyes. It's been bad place. Seen by people who do bad things. You are not that at all. I want you to fulfill your potential. When you step into the ring in your hometown at Full Gear, everything you've done has been easy, not this. Moxley celebrates as we will see Jamie Hayter versus Sky Blue next. A promo package for the Elite plays evolving out clock and the boys going back in time with a bunch of steampunk gears, teasing their return on November 19th. Commercial break. Promo package hyping up the 2 out of 3 falls match with Sammy Guevara and Brian Danielson. Brian and said Sammy represents all the disrespect from Jericho Garcia. Really, I am going to use it to kick his head in. Alright, so we get Jamie Hayter versus Sky Blue. This match right here, this was solid. Solid match. Jamie Hayter makes her way to the ring with a massive pop as she's over with the crowd. She flanked by Rebel and Baker, who dejectedly walks down as well. Sky Blue makes her way out, but Toni Storm music hits. She's going to be in the corner of Sky Blue tonight, too, even the odds. Blue and Hater start quickly, but Hater rolls out quickly. Hater follows up with a whip into the rail and tries for a power slam, but Blue counters and sends her into the post. Both women back in now. Blue with a arm drag and a big knee strike. Baker grabs Blue's boot as Hater with a kick in a T-bone suplex as we go to commercial break. Back from the break, Blue fires off with some forearm strikes and follows up with a front dropkick. Sky takes out Reba and Britt at ringside and hits a crossbody on Hater. 1-2 no. Hater back with a boot and fights a full Nelson attempt. Blue with an enziguri and hits a sick code red. 1-2 no. Blue fires up as Hater rolls her up for a 2 count and immediately rocks with a thirst kick. Hater with an elbow shot as Blue comes back with a thirst kick of her own. She sends Blue into the corner and hits a series of chops. Blue up on the shoulders of Hater, but Hater knocks her off and hits a sick lariat. 1-2-3. The winner of the match, Jamie Hater. This was a solid match. Post-match, Hater celebrates as we run down the world title eliminator match between Brian Cage and Dante Martin. Cage hypes up his size, and Dante says the bigger they are, the harder they fall. Cage says, "I am not a man. I am a machine." Alex Marvez is in the back as Lance Archer has just destroyed Ricky Starks and says, "Everybody dies." Alex calls for help as we go back to the ring. Alright, so we get the main event of the evening. 2 out of 3 falls match. Sammy Guerrero versus Brian Danielson. This was a good main event match. This was fantastic. Sammy makes his way down, accompanied by Tay Melo, as she gives him a lucky smooch. Brian Danielson comes out next out of the heel tunnel as the crowd cheers him loudly. He looks ready to kill Sammy. No lie, Brian Danielson celebrates on the corner and stares Sammy down. All right, Brian immediately with a chop on Sammy, followed by an uppercut around kicks. Brian with another vicious chop and sends Sammy Guerrero into another corner. More chops and strikes as Brian just toys with Sammy and sends him into every turnbuckle. Sammy and Brian Danielson reverse a bunch of Irish whips, but Sammy with a dropkick. Brian Danielson blocks a toe and immediately hits a shotgun dropkick. Sammy Guerrero on the outside as Brian Danielson goes to fly, but Tay Melo gets in the way. Brian Danielson to the outside as Sammy Guerrero chucks a steel chair at Brian Danielson's face for a DQ. The winner by disqualification, Brian Danielson. Sammy Guerrero jams the microphone into the eyes of Brian Danielson and taunts the crowd before going back to elbowing Brian Danielson in the face as we go to commercial as the crowd chants F-U Sammy Guerrero. Commercial break. Back from commercial, Sammy is taunting in the corner and goes back to mouthing and striking Danielson. He is relentlessly throwing elbow and punches at Brian Danielson. It's busted open above his left eye. Brian tries to fight back, but Sammy doesn't let him get too far. Brian Danielson tries a strike, but Sammy goes for a vicious knee, then hits the GTH 1-2-3. The winner of the match, Sammy Guerrero. Alright, Bryce checks on Brian, and Sammy goes after him immediately, a series of uppercuts and chops. Sammy up top with Brian, and Sammy flips out. Sammy tries to leap up and slips on the ropes. Brian with a headbutt on Sammy and follows up with a diving headbutt but Sammy avoids and gets the lebel lock on Brian, struggling to get the ropes and tries to roll through, but Sammy keeps the hold on. Brian Danielson gets to his feet and literally carries Sammy Guerrero, but it's too much as Brian Danielson is down again. Brian is also bleeding from the nose as he managed to get to the ropes and break the hold. Sammy Guerrero with chops and elbows, but Brian Danielson returned their favor and now a series of headbutts. Brian Danielson counters Sammy Guerrero with a huge flying knee as he was coming off the top. Both men are down as we go to commercial break. Back from the break, we see Bryce ejecting Tay Mello. She grabbed him doing a pinfall. Apparently, she's gone. Brian Danielson and Sammy Guerrero are slugging it out as Brian is bleeding even more now. Sammy pokes the eyes of Brian, but Brian counters with a suplex into the corner as Sammy is in the tree of woe. Brian Danielson with sick kick and falls with the delayed baseball slide drop kick. Brian Danielson has Sammy up top now and trying to elbow him, but Sammy counters with a vicious flying knee. Sammy with a shooting star press onto the floor, onto Brian. The crowd chants, you still suck. Sammy Guerrero tries for the Sammy cutter, but Sammy gets tripped in the lebel lock. Brian Danielson has it chanted in, but Sammy eventually cross and makes his way to the ropes. Sammy on his knees as Brian Danielson with more kicks to the chest, leaping knee by Sammy and goes for the GTH. Brian Danielson drops out in a sick poison runner by Brian Danielson. Brian Danielson fires up and hits the bazooka knee, but Sammy holds on and hits the lion tamer on Brian. Center of the ring as Brian makes his brave crawl to the ropes. Sammy Guerrero face wash Brian and gets Brian up for the GTH, but Brian falls off and hits the bazooka knee. Brian with the wrist lock as Sammy counters with the insane moonsault DDT, but Brian Danielson blocks a senton follow Brian's with elbows to the jaw of Sammy and locks in the lebel lock again. Brian wrenches back even harder as Sammy crawls, but Brian Danielson traps the arm as Sammy Guerrero pass out. All right, the winner of the match, Brian Danielson. The commentary run down the car for Rampage as the show goes off the air. All right, like I mentioned before, AEW Dynamite was a good show. If you guys enjoy my AEW Dynamite review on highlights, please give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below on what are your thoughts on AEW Dynamite. And I cannot wait for AEW Full Gear. But anyway, if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, turn on post notifications when I premiere a brand new video at 3 o'clock Eastern Time. Follow my social media, my Twitter, my Instagram, my TikTok, and Twitch, and Discord down below in the description. And I will go live tomorrow on YouTube. So I'll see you guys live on YouTube tomorrow. That's all I got said here. But anyway, this your boy, B-Boy Fashion TV. Have a great night. Stay safe and always stay positive. Believe in yourself and keep motivating yourself. This your boy, B-Boy Fashion TV. Kept your crew, kept your kings. Too sweet. I'm out of here. Gang.